Hi, today I'm going to show you how to measure the cross-section of a stream. First, I'm going to need a measuring tape. In this case, I've got one that's 50 metres for measuring the width of the stream. This is more than enough. I'm also going to need a metre ruler for measuring the depth of the stream. Now, if the stream is deeper than a metre, I'm going to need something more substantial, such as a surveying pole. Now, once I've gathered my data, I can create a cross-section diagram. Now, before we get started, also remember that rivers and streams are dangerous environments. Great caution must be taken. Do not enter a stream if it is raining, as there could be a flash flood. First, I'm going to find the width of the stream by stretching this tape measure from one bank to the other. My starting point will be where the bank meets the stream. Now, something I really want to avoid is the tape making contact with the river. And this is because it will increase the distance measured, which therefore will make my readings inaccurate. What I want to do is keep the tape about 20 centimetres above the water. My end point will be where the opposite bank meets the stream. Now to measure the stream, I'm going to take my measurements at 50 centimetre intervals. Now, if this stream weren't so wide, I'd make the intervals shorter. But as it is, I'm going to take my first reading. I'm going to stick my metre ruler in the water. And I can see that this section is 20 centimetres deep, so I'll record it on my piece of paper. Now, here at the 2 metre mark, as you can see, it's even deeper. It's about 31 centimetres. As you can see at the 5 metre mark, put my ruler in, and it's 16 centimetres. As I take each measurement, I will yell out the depth to my assistant, who is recording the data.
19 centimetres!
They will have a pre-drawn data table that might look something like this. When holding your measuring ruler, it is best to have the edge of the ruler facing upstream to reduce the surface area that is exposed to running water. That way, the ruler is less likely to bend. You don't want it like this, because if that happens, you might increase the size of the measurement, making your data inaccurate. Now we have finished taking our data collection, we are ready to turn our data into a cross-section graph. But unlike a normal cross-section graph, where zero starts at the bottom, in this case zero is going to start at the top and will take our measurements downwards. For instance, this completed example from today's measurements.